Welcome to having better hair days more often. This is the first step you need to take to getting those amazing days ahead. This is the bombshell playbook that we are going to be unpacking today. This is the first step that you want to follow as a part of the Becoming Bombshell method that will prepare you for effectiveness for the next two steps. The first question that we want to ask is, what are your unique beauty traits? This question involves, what type of hair do you have? Do you have curly hair? Do you have coily hair? Do you have wavy hair? Or do you have straight hair? Understanding what you're working with will help us understand where you are and where you want to be regarding your hair goals. And I have some notes, so I'm going to stay on track. So bear with me here. What are your strands like? When you look at a piece of your hair and you compare it to a piece of copy paper or a piece of sewing thread, is your hair diameter smaller than the thread, or is it about the same size, or is it kind of in between? This will help you understand whether your hair is fine, medium, or coarse. Fine hair can tend to get damaged. It can be hard to work with. It frizzes up easily. Medium hair is one of the most optimal hair types to have, although that's not saying that it's without problems. This hair type is typically more responsive to styling. It holds in moisture better. Coarse hair has its own set of problems. It's the strongest hair type, but it can tend to resist styling and color treatments. The next is porosity. You want to understand what type of hair porosity you have. So you're going to pluck out one of your strands, you're going to get a glass of water, and you're going to put that strand in the glass of water. And if it sinks to the bottom immediately, that means it's high porosity. It means your hair is ready to absorb all the things, which can be a disadvantage because it can let go of a lot of things too. We'll cover more about that in the bombshell blends portion of this process. The next one is low porosity. If your hair sits at the top for a while and then slowly sinks to the bottom, you have low porosity, which means it's really tough for those helpful vitamins and solutions to take effect into your hair. We'll also cover how to address this type of porosity in the bombshell blends portion. The next thing you want to understand is your scalp. Is your scalp flaky? Is it oily? Is it a combination of both? What's kind of going on there? There are several things that you want to do with your scalp. Number one, you always want to make sure that you're rinsing out your product completely. Number two, you want to make sure you're being gentle with your scalp. Do not overbrush it. Do not use force on that scalp. It's tender. It's like your face skin. Be gentle with it. Don't use your fingernails to scratch at your scalp. That can create sores. It can hinder hair growth. What you want to do is you want to use your finger pads to massage in your shampoo or your different treatments into your scalp. It'll be great. It'll help boost the circulation in your scalp and it will help with hair growth. The second question we have is, what are the internal influences at work against your hair? And this is going to include hormones. You want to be on top of your hormones. Now, I know as ladies, our hormones change once a month. But if you have severe stress, then your hair will feel the effects of that up to 3 months later. And some of that can include excessive shedding. So keep that in mind. You want to figure out if you have any disease like alopecia that's kind of creating any of these issues. If you have hormones, get them balanced. It's going to make such a difference in your energy. If you're having low energy levels, fatigue, brain fog, all the things, you want to make sure that you visit this with your doctor, and you want to also check out your nutrition. Nutrition is key for having healthy hair. If your body doesn't have what it needs, then it's not going to give you optimal health. It's not going to give you your optimal hair. The third question and the last question we're going to ask is, what are those external influences that are affecting our hair? Let's talk about the weather. The weather is a big one. If you live in an environment that's humid, whether it be cold or hot, this is going to have a big influence on your hair, especially depending the porosity that you have. Your hair can tend to get bloated and just absorb all the things and can lead to frizziness. Weather, if it's dry, oh my goodness, your poor skin and your poor hair is going to be fighting against the environment, trying to take all the good things out of it. Another thing you want to look at is your water. Is your water hard? What you're going to see with that is you're going to see buildup on your dishes, you're going to see buildup on the shower, and just like mineral deposits everywhere. These mineral deposits are not awesome for your hair. Basically, they leach your hair of goodness and makes it harder to style. It can lead more prone to dryness. With soft water, you can get a filter to build the soft water. It's going to be kinder for your skin. It's going to be kinder for your hair. You are going to spend a teeny bit more time rinsing it out though. So you want to make sure you're using those fingertips to really work that product out of your scalp. There are some other things that you can do to help against those external factors. Number one is be gentle with your hair. When it's wet, make sure that you're taking your hair gently. Treat it with kindness. And you're gonna gently squeeze that water out of your hair. Don't wrap it up and wring it out. Your hair is very delicate when it's wet. So be sure if you're combing it out, you want to use a wide tooth comb or a wet brush. Start from the bottom and work your way up to the top as you work those tangles out of your hair. If you're using heat styling, watch the heat. 400 degrees is like almost broil in an oven. So step back on the heat a little bit to protect your hair. Also, when drying, before you hit the blow dryer, make sure that you absorb any of the excess water in your hair with a microfiber towel. It will decrease that friction. It will be kinder to your hair and you'll get better results. Also, having a silk pillowcase really helps. It's really kind on your skin and it's really kind on the lengths of your hair. Keep in mind that having better hair days is a process. Give the Bombshell Method a 90-day commitment. Take a picture right now. You're gonna wanna remember where you started when you started your hair journey. This is going to be a transition. Your hair is gonna be getting rid of some gunk, probably. So you're going to have potentially a little bit of stickiness. You're going to have some new growth. So it's going to mean a little bit of shedding of the old and the dead, but ultimately you're going to have gorgeous, healthy hair, the type of hair that you dreamed about. So take that picture that we talked about, give it 90 days. I'll be walking you through the entire process. When you take that picture, you can save it on your phone or you can post it on social media. Tag me, Kristen Solomon, on Instagram and use the hashtag #BecomingBombshellMethod. I'm excited to see where you're going and drop any comments below if you have any questions, and I'll see you in the next video.